I realize that these excerpts from Blue Magic Woman will never give you an idea of the plot, but I'm hoping that they will give you an idea of the writing style and enough that it will make you want to look further into the book. This is from chapter 5, called The Pass. Michael watches the sun through a hole in the frost on the hospital cafe window. Not only does it let in rays of light, but also suddenly, Brigitte's cafe au lait face. She stands looking in it at Michael and motions for him to join her outside. He stands up and wonders if someone else has been running with his feet. Maybe I'm a multiple personality like Brigitte. He pulls his tired legs to the door. Outside, he squints into the light, cerulean mists of morning. Brigitte's pupils reveal she is scared, but she asks with a smile, "Do you want to take a walk with me, now that I'm released from that locked ward?" "Where can we walk?" Michael queries, dismally looking around at all the gray buildings. "Down to the river. We can't leave the hospital grounds, but I need the sun. In my last ward, we had a crazy caged bird, and I must have caught a cold from it." Waiting in vain for a response from Michael, Brigitte, clad in just a light jacket and tight jeans, shivers in the freezing weather. Michael's snug coat reminds him of the straitjacket that was forced on him the first night in the hospital, after he started swinging his fists. The collar of his jacket bites into the sores on his neck, but neither movement nor twist of his body relieves the pain. It is a reminder of his near death, the wearing of a wooden tuxedo. Michael follows Brigitte's lead through a small wood, down toward the frozen river, where among the trees, large boulders dot the landscape, like kneecaps of Swedish mythical giants, sleeping under a fairyland blanket of snow. While the sun shines, winter delays further attacks. The landscape captures a chance to catch its breath, as does Michael, until Brigitte breaks the silence. "How come you have those scars on your wrists? I saw them yesterday." "Something happened in Munich, but I don't want to talk about it," Michael replies slowly and defensively as they reach the river. Brigitte changes the subject. "Michael, my father's a veterinarian, but can you believe he loves to go hunting whenever he has free time?" says Brigitte with indignation. "Besides, all the horned trophies, he collects live animals. He has 700 pigeons housed in our backyard. My mother collects dresses and drinks. I think it's better to collect letters of passion from a lover." Brigitte's voice evaporates into the frigid air. "My mom collects golf trophies," announces Michael. "It's funny. I've never collected anything except gum wrappers when I was a kid. And then I found out that I was actually collecting ants instead. My drawer suddenly had more ants than gum wrappers." His story falls flat as his voice awkwardly adds, "You have beautiful hair, Brigitte. Could I collect things from you? I could start with a lock of your lovely hair." "I guess so. I do need a haircut," she replies, laughing at last.